guys, today I'm going to be teaching you how to do a French braid. So you're going to need, of course, obviously you're going to need your doll, a brush, and a band. So you're going to basically just brush their hair back. A French braid usually works on like any doll's hair. If it's like longer, like it probably wouldn't work on like Chris's hair, or like just like you doll number 35 and stuff like that. So if your doll has like short hair, then that wouldn't work out very well. So you're just gonna brush it all back and make sure that you get all those tangles out. Then you're gonna start on the top of her head and like separate all of it, like just like make a top section kind of. So a brush really helps like brush all the stuff under it. Then you're gonna brush that. And yeah, you really want to keep it from getting tangled while you're doing this, though. So you're gonna separate it into three parts, just like if you're doing a regular braid. And except on this one, of course, you're going to braid all the way down. So you always start on the top of her head, and you're gonna take that one over, this part over, and this part over, except while you're going. The difference is on a French braid, when like you twist over, you get some from the side and you bring it over too to make the that part of the braid like bigger, I guess. It's kind of hard to explain that. Anyway, you're gonna take that and then add some more hair to it. So yeah, basically what a French braid really is a braid that starts on the top of your doll's head, and you just like connect more hair to it as you go. So, and if it starts to get messy or tangled, you could just brush the parts while it's still separated. And yeah, so you're just gonna keep going down. And yeah. This one isn't turning out very well, but it's okay. It's kind of just like, I'm kind of just like showing you. Like, I'm not really taking my time on this one. But mostly, like, you should probably take your time on, like, when you're doing French braid, because, like, sometimes you get trying to hurry up this process because like we need to get to the bottom like this. So yeah, and when you're doing a French braid, again, you need a longer hair doll. Her hair doesn't have to be as long as this doll's, because this doll's hair is really, really long. But yeah. And I really like doing French braids on like Josefina and stuff, because like since Josefina's hair is so long, it's usually in a braid or a bun because I don't want it to get messed up or anything. So yeah, I like putting her hair in braids and stuff. And yeah, I'm just doing this tutorial because like in case like you really want to do French braids. You're gonna take this part over. And then now we're at the bottom part. So you're gonna separate the bottom parts into three parts like this. And connect it to those. Yeah. And then you're gonna just keep braiding on down. So the bottom part's really easy. It's just like a regular braid. And on this part, you're going to need a rubber band. One second. When I was just a girl, I thought I had it figured out. See, my life would turn out right, and I'd make it here somehow. Now, put the rubber band on the end, and you're done. So now I'm going to show you what it looks like. this is what it's gonna look like in the front. See, it's just braided all the way down there. So that was how to do a French braid, and I hope it helped.